guys, how are you doing? This is another video, another just a few things video in which I share some thoughts, show you guys some things, talk about stuff, just a few things. First, I want to tell you guys, if you hear some bag noises from people working, the apartments next to us have been bought by someone and he rented Polish employees who work for two marbles and a piece of shit until a time normal people have dinner, you know, so they are just, I finished work today and they're still working, so I can't shut them up. First, I want to address one subject I've been talking about in my previous video, and it's really sad that I need to explain myself, but some people really don't get it. And I'm talking about the death of the vocalist of Suicide Silence, Mitch Lucker. Like I said, it's really sad that I need to talk about this again, but I'll just talk about it and then I'll just close the entire topic and I'll never talk about it again. In my video, I gave the people who care about Mitch Lucker, his family, his fans, and whoever, my condolences. I just wanted to show the people that I'm a grown-up, and I said that I thought it was strange that people first say I'm not a fan, as if you need to defend yourself or as if you need to say I'm not a fan to show that you're not a deathcore fan, you know, God forbid that people think you're a deathcore fan. I said it as well and people were like, oh, you blame us and you say it yourself. I only said it because I knew there were gonna be people, and they even put it in the comments, I knew there were gonna be people that said, why do you care for the singer of Suicide Silence when you don't even like the music? And that is why I said, I don't like the music, but I just want to give my respects because, you know, if it's metal or not, I'll be the judge for myself. I think deathcore is just a part of metal. And I know that people are at home are going to be like, what? Blasphemy! Fuck you. I think it's a part of metal. And if you disagree, fine. Whatever. And there's a big name passed away in the metal scene. Whether you like it or not, Mitch Lucker had a big band with a big fan base and a big name, so it's sad. And I just wanted to show my respect as a metalhead who just respects all sorts of music and even deathcore, so I just wanted to pay my respects. And that is why I said, I'm not a deathcore fan, you guys know that, but there are gonna be people complaining, so that's the only reason why I said it. If not for those people, I wouldn't have said it. I mean, I also got Dio music, and I'm not the biggest Dio fan, but in my video for Dio, I also didn't say I'm not the biggest Dio fan, but rest in peace, you know? So, that was the reason. Now there's new news came to the surface that he got intoxicated, he got drunk, he stepped on his bike, drove off and killed himself. I'm not gonna say that's a good thing. I'm not gonna defend that. There's no reason why you would get drunk and get on a bike or in a car and drive off and take the risk of injuring someone else and, you know, taking your own life in this case. I don't have respect for drinking and driving. There's no reason why you would combine that. But it seems that there are more people comfortable now with bashing on his death, now that they know that his death is caused by himself. And now people say, like, it's not sad, he had it coming, he deserved it. And I don't think he deserved it. He had it coming, of course. I mean, he did it himself. He got drunk and he stepped on his bike. I still think it's sad. It's sad that a guy makes a decision like this, and in this news report, it was from his wife. His wife said they got in an argument, correct me if I'm wrong, he got drunk, stepped on his bike, drove off and killed himself. It seems that more people are comfortable now with shitting over his death, and I still think it's sad that his decision caused him to kill himself. Just like, for example, Amy Winehouse, who also killed herself. I also thought that that was sad, that she was not capable of getting out of her addictions to make herself better and to just, you know, be a good vocalist, because I thought that Amy Winehouse was a good vocalist. I liked her voice and some of her songs. So yeah, a non-metal person. Yeah, that's a artist that I liked. But I also thought that that was sad. Just as much as I think that it's sad that Mitch Lucker made a decision that cost him his life. But let's be honest, when I uploaded my video, that news was not known yet, or with a few people, but not with the most people. And he already had shit covering his death. You know, there were already people who thought it was necessary to mock his death and to ridicule his death. And that is what I was trying to say in this video. There was even a fucking dumbass who said, like, you take 30 minutes to say rest in peace, Mitch. My video was about the mockery after people's death. I mean, Paul Gray, what did Paul Gray do to deserve all the shit that he got after his death, except for being a member of Slipknot? What did a ref do? A lot of people said, what if Mitch took someone's life? What if it could have happened this? Yeah, it could have, and what if, but that does not apply because it didn't happen. So let's stick to the facts. I think it's sad, and I think it's really fucking sad, I don't have any words for this kind of shit, that people think it's necessary to mock someone's death. That was my point in the video, and I used Mitch as the most current example, and that is why I also used the ref of Avenged Sevenfold. The ref was the drummer of Avenged Sevenfold. I forgot that in my previous video. And Paul Gray, the bass player of Slipknot. I used those examples to tell you guys that I think all this mockery after people's death is really fucking shit. And like I said, I don't respect people who drink and drive, but that was not my point. I still think that's sad. It's a stupid decision to go drinking and driving. Of course, there were even people who said, like, oh, so you can't talk about the death. And I mean, how do you come up with this shit? There were people who say that told me, if you can't talk ill about the death, then what about Hitler? And I was like, come on. You know, I mean, if I talk about a guy like Mitch Lucker who made a bunch of people happy, I'm talking about people like death. You know, I mean, if I could have, I would have killed Hitler myself. You know, I mean, I'm not talking about people like that. Osama bin Laden, Hitler, Stalin, whoever. You know, I'm not talking about people like that. If they die, fine, you know, let's celebrate that shit. People like Mitch Lucker, if you compare that shit, if that shit comes up in your mind like, what about Hitler, then please don't talk at all, you know, I mean, please. So, basically, I still think it's sad that Mitch Lucker died because of his own decision, and I don't think it would have mattered if he would have gotten a heart attack or killed himself with his bike. I think the shit level would have been the same, and he only gets shit over his death because he was the singer of Suicide Silence, and that's period. That's the truth. There's absolutely no justification for all his shit just because you say, like, yeah, he killed himself and he was the singer of Suicide Silence. You can just show a little bit of respect, and if you don't respect it, fine. But there's no point in shitting over his death just because he's the singer of Suicide Silence. If you use that argument, then get the fuck off my channel. I blocked a bunch of people after my video. There were people said, like, glad he's dead and see him in hell, blah blah blah, and all that kind of shit. If you post comments like that, I block your ass immediately. I don't want to have anything to do with you as a person. Get off my channel. And if not, I'll help you a little bit. So that was my idea behind the video. That is what I wanted to make clear, and I used Mitch, Paul, and the ref as an example. Now, that wasn't too hard, was it? I don't think it was. So, let's get on with the next subject. To stay a little bit into the bad news, and don't worry, it's not gonna be one big bad news video. When I came back from Malta, I learned that Matt and Tom from Dissolvent have quit the band Dissolvent. And if you don't know Dissolvent, well, you actually hear them in the beginning of every video of mine, because the intro song is called March of the Infidel. Matt and Tom created it. It's a song for me and about me. And if you want to hear the full version, I'll just put a link over there, and one in the description, and maybe to another song as well. But I just wanted to send out my hails to Matt and Tom, And of course, thank you for the song March of the Infidel and for the bottle of whiskey that you guys sent me. And if you ever get a new project going on, just keep in touch and I'll see what I can do for you guys with some video footage. You know me, it's never a problem. So I'll talk to you guys later and take care. So around 2 weeks ago, I posted a contest on my Facebook, and you'll probably wonder why not a video. Well, I wanted to make the chances to win a little bit bigger this time. I wanted to try something different on Facebook for the people that follow me on Facebook, follow my statuses that I post, and I just wanted to see if there were enough people enthusiastic to take this away. And there were a lot of people enthusiastic, actually. I went through my DVD collection a little while ago, and I came across this box. It's Best of Horror, 20-pack, 20 movies, a collection of the best horror movies. It has Phantom of the Opera, Shock, Macabre, The Werewolf Shadow, Dracula 3000, Curse of the Devil, Ebola Syndrome, and a lot more. And I was like, I've seen these movies, and should I just throw them away, or should I give them to someone else? And I was like, you know, maybe it's a little bit of a waste to throw this all away. And I didn't even know someone who would like this, so I thought, let's make a fun contest out of this. So I told the people on Facebook, if you have any Photoshop skills or paint skills, now's the time to take them out. So I gave them the assignment, to call it like that, pick one of my photos, pictures with me or Baldrick or my logo, and just take it from there. Just, you know, let your creativity flow. Create something funny, something cool, something serious, something awesome, just with paint or Photoshop. Just take it away. I gave them 2 weeks to figure something out, and I got a lot of responses, a lot of funny pictures, and a lot of cool stuff. And I picked one winner. I posted it on my Facebook, telling the people, like, I picked this guy for the winner, and most people were like, fucking hell, that's awesome. He really did an awesome job. And I'll put your name under the picture at the end of the entire row, because I'm gonna show you guys a bunch of the responses that I got, a bunch of the pictures that I got, and his at the end, and I'll put his name in it, and you'll see winner, so you know that is the winner, and then you'll understand why I picked his picture as the winner. So congratulations, I'll send the box to you as soon as possible, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Oh, I'll just guide it with a little bit of music from, I don't know, Saito Talkshow. Speaking of cytotoxin, by the way, since yesterday their new album Radiophobia, which is this one, and this is not the official album, this is their album that they sent me, the pre-listening video, especially for me. But it has new songs on it. That's the cover of Radiophobia. It's out now, so just to remember you guys, the new cytotoxin is out. I'll put a link to the cytotoxin Facebook or their Big Cartel or whatever. Just contact the band, ask them where you can buy the album. But not to forget, also the new Beheaded album is out. Never to Dawn, of course. So, like with cytotoxin, I'll put the Big Cartel and the Facebook of Beheaded in the description so you guys can contact them and order their album, or just ask them where you can order the album. So remember, the new cytotoxin and the new Beheaded are out since yesterday. Go get them. And I'll just wait for cytotoxin and Beheaded to send me an album or something. Just, you know. So I got some good news for people who like thrash metal, and a lot of people ask me, do you like thrash metal? Well, I'm a big fan of it, actually. I got some bands coming up, some promo bands for you guys, which are thrash metal. But I was also thinking about making a thrash special, just talking about thrash metal and showing you guys some bands that I have, some CDs that I have. I'll give you guys a little example, because I've been buying a lot of thrash metal lately. I got these new. This is, I hope you guys can see it, Guillotine, Blood Money, really tight thrash metal, and of course with art of Ed Repka, who also did art for Death, Megadeth, and a lot of others. So that's a cool album that I got. I got an album from Hatchet, Awaiting Evil. I saw this on YouTube a little while ago, and I was like, this sounds actually pretty cool, so I bought the album. Really cool album. And then I got two albums of Defiance. These two. I just hope you guys can see it. This is, I have to check this, Void Terra Firma from Defiance. Really cool. And then I have this one, Product of Society, also with art of Ed Repka. Really cool album. And then this one in the back, so I don't have to zoom in this time. I'll just take this one out. This is a little bit thrash death. It's really tight, aggressive thrash metal with a twist of death metal, but it's this one, Eliminator, Breaking the Wheel. This is some nasty, sickening shit. Really fucking awesome. I've been searching my balls off for this one. Still haven't, but I finally found it. Really cool album. If you like thrash metal, really fast, really aggressive, go check this one out. Go check if you can find it. Really cool. So, if you like thrash metal, keep an eye on my channel, stay tuned, and if not, I'll just send Baldrick your way.
Make you an offer you can't refuse, huh? You like horses, huh? Yeah, you like horses.
Yeah, so, you know, just, yeah. So lately there were a bunch of people that asked me why my current videos are a little bit darker. Well, that's because actually it's really simple. It's winter. By the time I get home, it already starts to get a little bit dark, and well, by the time I'm done taking a shower and dressing myself to get in front of the camera, it's dark outside. So that is why my current videos are a little bit darker than the previous ones, and I don't have a whole lot of light in my house. You would think different with all the terrariums, but that doesn't really work. So, you know, by the time it gets summer again, I'll just have more light in my videos. That's actually why. If you guys have a camera at home, you might want to get it and keep it in front of you, because really soon I'm gonna have a video for you guys, which I'm gonna need you guys for. The band Meadows End is planning on making a video, and they need you guys to be in that video. I'm gonna explain it more when the video arrives, but just get ready for it. They need you to be in that video. So if you like Meadows End, if you like melodic death metal, but this it's for their new album. It gets really tight, actually. I listened to a couple of new songs. It sounds really good, and they just need your help to make this video. So get a camera, and if you don't have one, get one from someone else. It's coming up really soon. After this video, I'm gonna do a Malta Death Fest video because I still have Malta Death Fest footage, and after that one, I'm not gonna be finished still because I got a lot of Malta Death Fest footage. But after that one, I'm gonna do the Meadows End video, and it's gonna be awesome. It's gonna be a project. It's gonna contain me. It's gonna contain Baldrick, if he wants, and of course the guys themselves, and they're gonna need you. But more of that in the new Meadows End video, which is coming up really soon. And then to close this video and talking about thrash metal, I'm gonna let you guys listen to a piece of music from the band Conflagrator, and I hope I pronounced that correctly. I'll just show it to you guys. There you go, Conflagrator. And I've been talking to Alex, who does the guitars and the backing vocals for Conflagrator. I think that was wrong, but anyway. And he told me, like, you know, we have two demos, an EP or a demo, and this demo is from 2011. And do you even like thrash metal? And just like I said, I really do love thrash metal. And not every band needs a full-fledged, full-length album to send to me to have a little bit of attention in one of my videos. I once got an album sent by someone who told me, like, I don't have footage on the internet, but I want to send you my album, or at least a demo, and would you put it in one of your videos, at least a little piece. And I was like, well, I first need to listen to it, because when I think it's shit, then, you know. And he insisted on sending it to me, and I was like, okay, just send it to me. And then it came in, and he was like, what do you think? And it sounded as if he recorded it with the first phone which you can which you record sound with, you know, like. And I was like, I can't let people listen to this in one of my videos, you know. It sounds like it's been recorded from a helicopter, you know. And he got really upset. I was like, okay, from that moment on, I first want to listen to the music, and then I'll decide to, you know, just to send it to me. But Conflagrator. It's not a word we would use in Dutch, so that is why I put my tongue in a twist. It's really good. I think it really has a lot of potential. And I just wanted to let you guys listen to it, and I want to thank Alex for the two demos. And I'm just going to pick the second song from this demo, which is The Brutal Truth. And I hope you guys like it. I'll put a link to their Facebook or wherever they are in the description. Ow. Damn it. So, Alex, thank you very much for the demos, and I hope you guys like Conflagrator, and I'll see you guys next video.